when we start to think of the huge array of products that are out there, right? There's, you know, not only different types in terms of like liquid versus capsules, and then obviously the different manufacturers that are around. What would you sort of start to tell anyone who is looking for a product, things that they might want to have a checklist about as they're sort of navigating the different products, and what would probably be the best sort of investment as they choose what to buy?
That's a great question. When you're out purchasing these kinds of products for yourself, so ideally, if you've got, if it's been recommended to you by a healthcare practitioner or a naturopath, they'll have vetted that for you. And so you can usually be pretty, feel pretty safe with what they're going for. Mm-hmm. If you're out there on your own, it can be a little overwhelming for sure. You're going to have like that, you know, that famous big wall of protein powders. You're just like, yeah. I don't know what to do with this. So, basics, usually kind of what some of the first things that will kind of clear out a lot of the maybe not so great companies is it organic? Is it non-GMO? You know, some basic certifications like that will often help you kind of focus on some of the better quality products right from the get-go. Mm-hmm. You might also look, there's a new certification now coming up. Not a lot of companies have it, but it's glyphosate free residue, glyphosate residue free mm-hmm. certification. So those are some of the things you can actually, glyphosate is that what's in the Roundup. It's the one that a lot of people are struggling with. Mm-hmm. So those are some of the kinds of certifications you can look for. And then beyond that, this is where it's not necessarily written on the bottle. This is where you might want to talk to the staff at the store, or you might want to talk to your naturopath. But a good quality company will be what we call GMP certified. That stands for good manufacturing practices. And you'll want to ideally have all their products be tested independently. So it's not the company saying, I promise it's really good. Like, you want a third party independent lab testing for these products and confirming, yes, it's, you know, it's either, it is indeed gluten-free, or mm-hmm. this really is echinacea in here. We've identified it with DNA testing, for instance. You know, those are kinds of testings that not all companies are doing. But it's not necessarily always clearly on the label. So that's another level of kind of research you can go into. You're looking on their websites or speaking to the staff at the stores. Mm-hmm. So top would be organic, ideally non-GMO, maybe eco-responsible or sustainable or fair trade. Those kinds of things help. And then one little trick I often use as well is looking on the non-medicinal ingredients, which are usually really small on the bottle.
Yeah.
And if that's a really long list of a bunch of chemical words, there's probably a bunch of fillers in there that maybe weren't needed, maybe you don't really want. So you can try and look for companies that have less of that long list of non-medicinal ingredients as well. That's usually a better go.
And I think too, Dr. Orna, is we then need to understand how all of these practices that these companies might employ will then factor into cost. So when people yeah. are like, why is this one so cheap and this one's so expensive, and they're both, you know, just let's say, for example, vitamin D, there's reasons behind it. And if consumers can understand that, then it can, you know, lead to better choices.
Absolutely. It makes a really big difference, because sometimes it has to do with where they're sourcing their ingredients from. Like, for instance, that plays into the organic, or, you know, on and on. Mm-hmm. Sometimes it's because they're using real foods, which are going to be more expensive than synthetic molecules, for instance. Also the process involved, like what are the drying mechanisms? What machines are they using to compress and to create their tablets? Like, how are they extracting? Like, are they, what kind of alcohol are they using to extract the herbs? All of this is going to play into the quality and into the cost as well. Unfortunately, these are not necessarily always visible when you're looking at the wall of supplements in front of you.
Yes.
So hopefully, I mean, staff in stores more and more, a lot more than say a decade ago, are actually quite well trained in terms of the most of the products that they're selling. So use them as a resource as well.